Welcome, 640 West. We're out here ready to tell you about Ghana. We have brought Ghana to Atlanta, and we're going to find out how we can take the Atlantans and others all over the country back to Ghana and why. What's going on here, you beautiful people?
Greetings, family. We're getting ready to head out to Ghana May 24th to June 6th on our two-week journey of a lifetime to the motherland. And Ghana is one of those incredible countries. I've been there 11 times already. My sister Sass has been there 6 times. And we're the expert on traveling to Ghana, and want to reach out to you to let you know if you're looking to travel to the motherland in the future, especially Ghana, reach out to Bomani Tayamba and Sass at africafortheafricans.org. But the journey itself is a mix of roots, culture, business, investment, nightlife, shopping, networking. We're literally going to things like waterfalls, craft villages, Holocaust dungeons, a lot of networking.
W.E.B. Du Bois Memorial Site, the Kwame Nkrumah International Independence Day was celebrated there.
Absolutely, yes. 1957, yeah, yeah. 60 years ago. Yeah.
But here's the thing.
We're going for the 60th
anniversary. We want you to come with us. We want you to plan your journey of a lifetime too, because it's been so great for us, but we want for our brothers and sisters what we have for ourselves.
Absolutely.
This time, I understand there's something a little different about when you take your groups over. Not only are they seeing all the folks and all of the tourist aspects, but you have that economic building platform that's going on.
Yes, absolutely. I started out energy dealing with repatriation, and repatriation is that process of us leaving America, leaving the Americas which we were stolen and brought to, and returning to the land of our ancestors. And that's a process of when we return to the land of our ancestors, we want to be a part of nation building. I've heard nation building like loosely a lot, but nation building deals with us return to the land of our ancestors, actually building the continent, being a part of the growth and the development, participating in the investment, participating in aspects of tourism, and a lot of different things that's going on in Ghana. So your goal is not just to escape America when you're dealing with repatriation. Your goal is to be a part of that nation building aspect.
And to bring your skills home, that's me.
Skills transfer.
Look, we invest and give millions and millions of dollars, time, energy, talent, skills, etc. Our skills are transferable. My skill is transferable, so I await and look forward to putting the same zeal and enthusiasm into the building of this country as I do here. It's not an either or, it's a this and. It's about growth, evolution, and expansion.
And Brother Bomani, I understand that your tours that you do several times a year, normally 2 weeks, but this May trip, one, if not both of you, are going to be there a lot longer, right?
Yes, our staff will be there longer. We always encourage people, if you're looking to live and do business in Africa, spend the time and stay longer. When I first went to Ghana in 2006 and a few years from there on, I kept on staying back longer and longer and kept on doing more research as far as how it is on the ground and get a feel for the country. It's important when we do that repatriation that we do our research. A lot of times you have people that's just so frustrated with America, they just want to get up and leave. Mm-hmm. But I still tell people, if you're that frustrated, reach out to me, I got your back. I want to make sure that everybody that returned to the land of their ancestors, they're connected properly. And we have lots of connection, lots of networking.
Incredible.
We know
people.
Lots of people.
And here's the thing about the people and the networks that are already repatriated on the ground, been holding the space, building for 20s of years. These soldiers, and pioneering in that, have held the space for me to be able to step into when I'm ready to do my part to prepare for the generation of our young people that are not even yet born. See, this is something that is beyond me and my daughter that's 25. It's about those that aren't even born yet. So it's not like just me and my own ego driving this. This is a mission and a vision that I feel very called and determined to. And like I said, after many trips, 6, I'm just staying long enough to allow that which I feel in my spirit that the ancestors have ordained for me to happen. You know, and sometimes you can just let go and let the Creator have its way, even if it's in you. You know, and I feel very honored to be a part of Africa for the Africans this many times, and to be a part of the journey that's going to happen in about 33 days. But who's counting?
Yes, family, 5 more weeks and we're out of here. Now, so if you still want to come join us.
Now, you've identified some land, though. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
For the building of a whole new community?
Yes, since 2015, we've connected with our sister Nunet of Benue Village in Techiman, and she has been one of my greatest inspiration as my elder sister. And she recommended, she's like, Bomani, last year, at the beginning of the year, she said, Bomani, it's best if you guys get additional land by where we are and build a community so we can all connect together as a brother and sister African diaspora community. So that's like the greatest idea I ever heard in practical sense, based on someone who knows me and knows what we've been looking to do. And she's offered her services to make sure that we can come up there and get the land we need and build and just, you know, be a part of the growth of that whole region, the Bonhoeffer region.
It's a wonderful region, the Bonhoeffer region in Ghana. We went there 2 years ago.
Yeah,
it was like totally my first.